guys, back in time we go again. I believe this is a 2003 ration sent to me by my buddy Mark out of Cali. And here is another menu that I have not tried. It's menu number one, grilled beefsteak. I'm hoping it's kind of not like a McRib thing, but it probably will be. But let's check this thing out. Right off the bat, we can see this is by the AmeriQual Package Company. It has a peelable seal, and we'll see how lucky we are with it. Looks like I am destroying the bag more than anything else. That was a tough seal. Oh, look at those goodies in there. That's everything out of the bag. Right off the bat, beefsteak grilled, chunked, and formed. Yeah, okay. That's what's inside of it. And there's your nutrition facts. 3.2 ounces. That's the only problem I have with like these beefsteaks or beef patties is they are such a skimpy main. And you can see how ancient this is. Look at that heating element in there. Nowhere near like we've got this day and age. Hey, G. Schultz. Got some crackers. Beverage-based powder type orange. Beef snack strip. Might as well have some beef with your beef. Peanut butter. Of course, our spoon. Check out this accessory packet. I don't think I've had an accessory packet like this in quite a while. If ever, Mexican rice. Can't go wrong with that. Oh, kind of excited. I don't even know if I want to open this up. And we even have some interesting stuff. It's this accessory packet B. I know it's kind of hard to see that. But we also have like an Evansville identifier, like a number 5. And I'm trying to look at a date code in there. Maybe these are from 2000 because it says 0332. I believe that's what it says. No, it doesn't. It says 1038B. That's actually a B. And looking for a tear notch up here, it's actually on this side. It's on the bottom. Right there. Jeez. And then I fail opening it. Okay, nothing scary. It smells all right. Looks like we got some Tootsie Rolls because I can smell some chocolate right off the bat. The Tabasco sauce is still liquid. That's awesome. 2 Tootsie Rolls. Pack of matches. TP. Sugar. Moist towelette, salt, this is our non-dairy creamer. We should just call this in our packet of dry mold. And lastly, we have some spearmint gum. I actually have some high hopes for this meal. I hope it succeeds. At least it succeeds better than this poor ancient FRH, which probably won't. And just to confirm it, these are from 2000. Right at the end of 2000, this was the 353rd day, and this one is the 336th day of 2000. Man, 19 years ago. And it even has this cool old green packaging back from when I was in. And again, with the rice, it's always good practice to get this crunched up as much as possible. Knead it, break it up, so when you heat it up and it pours out, it doesn't come out into a solid mass. Same thing, give all of your stuff a good rub because it's been sitting in there for a long time. Well, maybe not everything a good rub, but you know what I mean. And we'll try this heater, and I'm even going to add an extra little bit of salt to see if that will help activate this thing. And I'm gonna add the salt. I'm gonna add the salt right now. Now, another good tip for your heater, if you fold these in like this, it makes it a lot easier to get inside of your ration containers or your FRH, as it were. All right, let's take a look at everything else while we're waiting for our mains and our side to heat up. It's a really huge, long wrapper just to pack that. Almost could have left that alone. Oop, yep, there's his. They just smell old and stale, but they're not bleached out. See how nice that is, how easy they pulled out, Nexus? Maybe we could use a little less air pressure in the current crackers that we're getting the military guys. Now, the peanut butter, you can see the outer edges are starting to delaminate a little bit, which that kind of has me a little nervous, but we're going to put a little on these crackers anyway. Yeah, the goal in sampling these older rations is to sample them, not necessarily to die. Well, it doesn't look too bad. Let's see what it smells like. You can definitely smell the oils in that. That might be a hit or miss. Guess we'll figure it out soon enough. Get our Tootsie Rolls. And let's make our drink. Whoa, that is putting out a heck of an off-gassing. Oh man, maybe the water will kill it. At least before it kills me. I'll actually have to eat my words on this heater. It ended up kind of sort of working. I mean, I can feel some heat coming off of this, but it is definitely spent. So let's take a look at our main and our side. And you can see why they got rid of those old heaters. It leaves a lot of residue. It's very reminiscent of what you would get in like one of those new Chinese issued MREs. All that white powdery kind of stuff stuck on these retort pouches. So here comes the grilled beefsteak, chunked and formed. It is substantially larger than a McRib. It's thicker, at least. It doesn't smell bad, which is always a plus as far as I'm concerned. And this Mexican rice, it didn't get heated up half as much as that, unfortunately. And right before you cut that Mexican rice up, just give that bag a good little crush. So again, it doesn't all come up in one large chunk and mass. It doesn't want to come out all the way. All right, there's still a bunch in there. And I'll take that more from a lack of heat getting all the way into this thing. And just so I can already do it, I'm going to crack the seal on our Tabasco so I can have that sitting right there. I'll put it right there on standby. And seeing how the spoon is already in this rice, I'm just going to give it a go. It looks a lot better than what I see in current rations because this actually has some beans in there. You can see some pepper, probably has a little bit of tomato in there, but I'll leave those ingredients right down there on the bottom. But I'll tell you what it does have a taste of. Dried out and old. It does have a little bit of spiciness to it. Man, the aftertaste with these things, and it's probably the beans. Oh, man. And this, at least adding water, made this smell a whole lot better. I can't believe I'm going to cleanse my palate with this stuff, though. Oh, this has a funky, like, acidic taste to it. Wow. Ooh, that kind of make my eyes water. Woo. And I don't want this beefsteak to cool down any more than it is. This is a dense piece of, what do they call it? Chunked and formed beefsteak. Man, look at that. Okay. We're just gonna do it. It's very chewy. It's very dense. That might be the better word. This sauce does kind of help. I have no idea what it is. Of course, I might scroll the ingredients if it kind of makes sense. It does have a nice flavor, but it is very salty. Unbelievably salty. I don't know. We'll just try a little bit of that. Maybe that will help kind of... Well, I'll tell you what. We'll do a little bit of this. It's not bad. It's not making any funky odors or anything like that. Tongue isn't going numb. That's always a huge positive sign. Oh, man. Okay. Beefsteak and Mexican rice. Yeah, this just has such a wicked aftertaste. Kind of like sweat sock gym feet. When you first try it, you're like, ah, it's not too bad. And then if you get like one of these little black beans in here, you're like, oh, that's not working. But oddly enough, this beefsteak is actually not too bad. Man, I think this would be like a Steve or Old Smoky special. They would just devour that. And it is a nice touch. You get the nice little grill lines on here. Very chic. Let's take a look at our Step Into a Slim Jim bar. Or perhaps I should call it a beef stick. Smells okay. Smells like a piece of beef jerky. Not necessarily an oil-infused piece of Slim Jim. Mm-mm. But I'll tell you what, boy, it tastes like a Slim Jim. Man, there's little Slim Jim sticks. It tastes like that, just slightly denser. You know, it's kind of got a little more of a bite to it, but it's still pretty soft for a beef steak or beef stick of beef jerky. Try one of my crackers on its own. These things, they just smell old. They're just old and tired. Well, kind of like me. Yeah, these steaks, they're just fine. These survive. Those are good. Now I'm kind of more curious about whether if the peanut butter did. I don't know. This kind of has like a slight tanginess, like a little bit of a rancidity to it. So I don't think I'm going to be messing with the peanut butter anymore. And really, the last thing to try is my Tootsie Roll. And of course, these things are bulletproof. You could probably find a K-ration that has an old Tootsie Roll in it. It'd be just perfectly fine. Yep, you can't go wrong with a Tootsie Roll. I have to be honest. I think if I'd have been in the military like in the year 2000, I think this probably would be a favorite. I could see everybody kind of liking this. Man, it's got this nice little kind of little spicy rice, which I happen to really enjoy. And this beef stick is actually pretty good too. Especially if you were lucky enough to get that little package of MRE bread, you could actually have like a steak sandwich. Save some cheese from another ration, have like a steak and cheese. This is actually pretty decent. I don't have any complaints with this other than I don't know why my drink beverage has failed. They usually don't do that. And you can see it's mixed. It's all the way through. But man, there's just something about that just did not survive. Well, everyone, this was a year 2000 ration. MRE packaged by Ameriqual. Menu number one, grilled beefsteak. This was actually pretty darn good. So if you happen to snag your hands on one of these, definitely give it a go. But of course, use your own common sense before you just start throwing food down your throat. All right, bye everybody. Thanks for hanging with me. And I will see you all on my next review. Bye.